let H be subgroup of G and A is some element in G, then AH is equal to H if and only if A belong to H. This is the second part. So here it is if and only if, so it is in two part. So first part, first part, let AH is equal to H, then we show this, we suppose, then we prove A belong to H. So this is given. So we can take any element from here, that means obviously we have shown that let A belong to AH. This we have shown because in this set the elements are AH, where A belong to G and H belong to H, but as H is subgroup, so H can be taken identity. So this I can show A belong to this, right? Why? Because H we can take identity. That means A we can write AE. So this belong to obviously AH, and this mean A belong to H as AH is equal to, as AH is equal to H. It is given. Now the second part. First part is done. Second part. Second part, let A belong to H, we prove AH is equal to H. This we prove. To prove this, we prove AH is contained in H and H is contained in AH. So first this part we show. Let X belong to AH. Then what is the form of H? Then X is equal to some this type of AH, right? And this belong to AH, this belong to H. Why? Since that means this is Y. Since if I take this equal to 1, if I take this equal to 1, since from 1 A belong to H and H belong to H, A belong to H and obviously H belong to H and H is subgroup, and H is subgroup, then it follow the closure property. This mean AH belong to H by closure, by closure. That mean and this element equal to x, this mean x belong to H. Now we started by assuming that x is element of AH, and we showed that x belong to H. This mean AH, this set is contained in H. So this is we can say some star. Now the other part we show. Okay, this I rub. Now we show H contained in AH. And what condition is given? This condition, because we are going from there to there, so this we already have assumed A belong to H, right? So in this H we have element of the type H. This we can write, let some element from this, obviously H belong to H. This is given, and H is subgroup, and H is subgroup. This is from where it is given. Also, A belong to H. This is from here. That means A inverse belong to H. And also one more thing, A inverse and H belong to H implies we can say A inverse H belong to H by closure property. Therefore, H I can write A into A inverse H. I can write like this because this become identity. Now this element is where? This element obviously belong to AH. Why? Because this element we have shown belong to H, and A is some element of G. That means this element obviously we took from H from here. So we can say H is contained in AH. So this we can say double star. So from star and double star we have H equal to AH, or AH is equal to H, right? Because we have showed here, we have showed AH contained in H, and here we have showed H contained in AH. So by this we have proved this result.